Good day, everyone. This is Dr. Soper here, and today I'll be presenting the first of three lessons about the fundamentals of the Python programming language. While I obviously can't cover every detail of Python programming in just a few videos, by the time you've completed these three lessons, you should have enough knowledge to understand and begin to work with Python projects. All of the examples in these lessons will be carried out using a Jupyter notebook, so if you're unfamiliar with Jupyter notebooks, then I would highly recommend that you watch the previous video in this series prior to embarking on your adventures in Python programming. To begin, let's briefly review what you'll learn in this lesson. By the time you have finished this video, you'll know about all of the following aspects of Python: how to display text, variables, arithmetic operators, and comparison operators. Along the way, we'll see illustrative examples and demonstrations of all of these skills and features of the Python programming language. Let's get started by learning how to display text in Python. To display a line of text in Python, we use the print function. The text that we want to display is passed into the print function inside its parentheses and is enclosed in single quotes. Generally, literal strings of text in Python should always be enclosed in single quotes. This is how Python knows that we're referring to a text string rather than to other text-based programming commands. Note in this example that there is a line above the print function that begins with a pound sign. This is called a comment. Comments are for human use only. They help us to remember what a section of code is intended to do, and can help other people understand our code more easily. Since comments are just for human use, Python will ignore them. If we want to include a line feed in our text output, we can use the /n, or new line, symbol, as shown here. Let's see a demonstration of these techniques. The first code cell in this notebook simply uses the print function to print a line of text to the screen. When I click on the Run button, the text, "Hello, my name is Dan," will be displayed on the screen. This next code cell demonstrates how we can use the /n new line symbol to display multiple lines of text with only one call to the print function. When I click the Run button, Python will print both lines of text to the screen. Next, let's learn about variables in Python. A variable is a symbolically named storage location in the computer's memory. Each variable has a name and a value, and the value of a variable can be changed whenever necessary. For example, we might use a variable to keep track of how many tickets have been sold for a concert. Every time an additional ticket is sold, we can update the value of the variable so that it reflects the correct number of tickets sold. Variables in Python can hold data of any type, such as text, integers, or floats, which you can think of as numbers with decimals, such as 123.67. To create a new variable in Python, we simply type its name and assign it a value. In this first example, we're declaring a variable named x and assigning it a value of 33. In this second example, we're declaring a variable named currentPrice and assigning it a value of 42.99. Note that the name of the variable goes on the left side of the equal sign, while the value that we want to assign to the variable goes on the right side of the equal sign. Also note that one equal sign means set equal to in Python. Thus, x equals 33 means set a variable named x equal to the value 33. Let's see a demonstration of variables being declared and used in Python. In the first part of this code cell, we declare three variables. The first variable is called product name, and its value is set to delicious nachos. The next variable is quantity sold, with a value of 33. And the third variable is unit price, with a value of 12.99. Again, note that text values are enclosed in single quotes. The next part of this code cell prints the values of the variables to the screen. Note that when used in this way, the plus symbol joins two strings of text together. This is called string concatenation. Also note that the str function is being used to convert numbers to strings, that is, to text. This allows us to print the numbers to the screen. Let's see what happens when we run this code cell. As you can see, Python prints the values of the variables to the screen. In this next code cell, we'll use a more advanced way of accomplishing the same thing by using the format function. Instead of doing all of the string concatenation ourselves, we simply type the output text in the way that we want it to appear, except that we use numbers inside curly braces as placeholders for the values that we want to appear. These numbers refer to the ordinal positions of the variables that we pass into the format function. 0, for example, refers to the first variable in the list, which in this case is the quantity sold. 1, then, refers to the product name variable, and 2 refers to the unit price variable. Thus, when we click the Run button, Python will take the values of these three variables and automatically insert them into our string at locations 0, 1, and 2. As you can see, the output is exactly the same as the previous code cell, except that we didn't need to do any string concatenation ourselves. Next, let's take a look at arithmetic operators in Python. Arithmetic operators allow us to perform mathematical operations on variables. To perform addition, we use the plus symbol. In this example, we begin with a variable named a, whose value is set to 5. We then declare a variable named b, and set its value to a plus 2, which yields 7. To perform subtraction, we use the minus symbol. In this example, we're declaring a variable named c, and setting its value to b minus 3. Since we know from the previous step that b equals 7, this means that the value of c will be 7 minus 3, which is 4. Similarly, we use the asterisk symbol to perform multiplication, and the forward slash symbol to perform division. In Python, 2 asterisks is the symbol for exponentiation. Thus, 2 asterisk asterisk 2 translates to 2 to the power of 2, or 2 squared, which of course equals 4. Finally, the percent sign in Python is used to perform a modulo operation, which returns the remainder after dividing one number by another. For example, 4 modulo 2 returns 0, because 4 is evenly divisible by 2. That is, there is no remainder. 5 modulo 2, however, would return 1, because 5 divided by 2 has a quotient of 2 and a remainder of 1. Let's see a demonstration of all of these arithmetic operators being used in Python. This code cell replicates all of the examples that we just discussed. We begin by declaring a variable named a and setting its value equal to 5, and then proceed to use our arithmetic operators to perform addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, exponentiation, and modulo operations. We then use the print function to display the results of all of these operations on the screen. Let's click the Run button to execute all of the code in this cell. As you can see, Python has performed all of the arithmetic operations and has displayed the results on the screen. All of the results match perfectly with our expectations, which is a good thing, because it shows us that we can trust Python to perform all of these mathematical calculations correctly. Next, we'll take a look at comparison operators in Python. Comparison operators are useful because they allow us to compare two different values and determine whether the relationship is true. In the examples below, we'll learn about all 6 of Python's comparison operators. In this example, we begin by declaring a variable named x and setting its value to 5. Our first comparison operator is two equals signs, which means is equal to. Note that this is very different from one equals sign, which, as we discussed earlier, means set equal to. Whereas is equal to is a test of whether one thing is the same as another thing, set equal to is a command or an instruction to change the value of one thing so that it matches the value of another thing. Returning to our example, here we're testing whether x is equal to 3. Since we know from the previous line that x is equal to 5, the result of this comparison will be false. Our next comparison operator is an exclamation point followed by an equal sign, and this combination means not equal to. As such, in this example, we are testing whether x is not equal to 7. Since we know that x is equal to 5, The result of this comparison is true. Our next two comparison operators represent greater than and less than, respectively. The first example tests whether x is greater than 14, which of course is false, because x equals 5. The next example tests whether x is less than 23, which, based on the current value of x, evaluates to true. Our last two operators represent greater than or equal to and less than or equal to, respectively. In the first case, the result is false, because x is not greater than or equal to 5. In the second case, the result is true, because the test is whether x is less than or equal to 5, and x is indeed equal to 5. Let's see a demonstration of all of these comparison operators. In this first code cell, we see all of the comparison tests that we just discussed. Since we know that the variable x is equal to 5, we know that the results should be false, true, false, true, false, true. Let's run the code cell to verify that Python performs all of these comparisons correctly. As you can see, the results match our expectations. This next code cell begins by asserting that x equals 33, and then tests whether x is less than 7. When we run the code cell, the result, of course, is false. If we change the value of x to negative 33, however, and then run the code cell again, the result will be true, because negative 33 is less than 7. At this point, you should have a good understanding of how to display text in Python, and how to use variables, arithmetic operators, and comparison operators in Python. In the next video in this series, you'll continue to develop your Python skills and knowledge by learning about lists, NumPy arrays, if statements, and logical operators. And I hope you'll join me for that lesson also. Well, my friends, thus ends our first lesson on the fundamentals of the Python programming language. I hope that you learned something interesting in this lesson, and until next time, have a great day.